All right, all right. There you go, Hoppity, and cotton socks, and cottony. Enjoy, enjoy a nice fresh pile of water lettuce just for you. You know, having a water lettuce salad is probably very, very refreshing. And look how cute these guys are! I cannot handle it. I can't wait to be able to see what some of their largos might look like as we begin to mix and match all sorts of slime genetics by feeding them other plorts. But for now, my friends, we have a whole bunch of happy hoppy slimes, and today we are actually going to be going out searching for none other than the tabby slimes, who I am mildly tempted to bring home and like put into a entire... what's this? Okay, good. I thought that was an escape cheekadoo. I'm kind of tempted to go home and maybe get some, or like to go get some tabby slimes and then put them over here, but I'm a little worried for our hen-hens. However, I think having tabby slime plorts might be very helpful, especially because they happen to be somewhat far away, and it does look like their plorts actually sell for quite a lot. Oh, phosphor plorts! All right, you guys. Oh, hey, Knight. Still working on cleaning everything up, are ya? Gotta love him, gotta love him. I almost forgot we do have our little phosphor plort down here, who I wanted to name like light bulb. Is he gone? Light! Oh no! Oh, there he is! Light, oh my gosh, come here. I can't believe he's still with us. As long as he stays in the cave system, then I think everything's going to be okay. I just need to figure out how to convince him to like stay down here. Ooh, maybe getting stuck there is the key. I know that seems a little inhumane, but maybe getting stuck there will actually keep him alive. Also some carrots. Yay! Okay, I should not be celebrating having pinned this poor little slime. Oh wait, no, there he goes. Having pinned him basically to a wall, but... Oh, and he eats fruit. He doesn't eat... Oh, I'm gonna need to bring him some fruit. All right, Light, I will be back in a little bit. You stay here so that you don't see the light and literally end up dying. And we're gonna carry on with our adventures today, my friends, which include trying very, very hard to get ourselves larger packs so that we can start feeding all of the like huge slimes we've been stumbling upon. We have found at least 3 of the Gordos. I think some of them... Yeah, you can see the phosphor Gordo is the one that's closest to home. And then we have been feeding the normal slime Gordo. And I did indeed see that there is a cotton Gordo who's ruling over one of the nearby valleys. I was just minding my own business, turned around and found him. Kind of like I was minding my own business, turned around and found a whole bunch of terrifying, tar recently too. But I do want to go ahead and... oops, are you good? Okay, goodbye! Boy, it always makes me nervous when the slimes decide to head into the slime sea themselves. Like, are you feeling okay, buddy? What's going on here? Ugh. But we do want to go ahead and see what the Gordos are hiding, because usually they're sitting atop quite a bit of useful treasure. And I think I'm sitting atop the Gordo. Like, he's really close. Hmm. No, he should be a little bit over here. We'll find him, we'll find him. But I think the sooner we figure out what territory they're hiding and what they've got tucked away, the better. Also, here's another one of these rocks. I'm so curious about that. Can I put the rock in the water and something happens? No. Huh. All right, you come with me. I feel like this is a significant thing. I just don't know what it does. Can I bring it home? All of the jellystone I collected last time got yeeted away in the chaos of trying to run away from a bunch of tars. All right, now where am I? Nowhere near where I was supposed to go. That's so interesting. But I guess it makes sense because I'm not used to like living here yet. Hey, this is where all the tars were last night because there's my jellystone. Whoops. All right, well, okay, look, if no, my water lettuce. If I'm gonna pick a plort to collect, it'll be these cotton plorts. There's another. Okay, yeah, so that little guy is no longer active. And he doesn't have anything to do with that interesting rock. And there's my jellystone that I absolutely need to collect. I need these. I need these, my friend. I mean, well, I can't complain about that. And then I think that, like, right around the corner somewhere here should be that tabby area, or should be that Gordo that I found. All right, there's a lot of food down here. And look, there's more jellystone here. All right, there we go. And I think there's even like a refinery link. Yeah, there's a refinery link further down. And then here's more carrots. We're gonna need a lot of food if we're gonna feed the Gordos. All right, this is adorable. I love being lost on my adventures because of course it is an adventure. If we get lost, you just have to keep going. One foot in front of the other and eventually it will show up somewhere. Possibly the place that would result in our intimate demise, but that's- I found him! I knew you were around here somewhere, you friend you. All right, I've got to go ahead and get a little picture of him because this is so freaking cute. Isn't he the most precious thing? All right, let's go ahead and feed this guy a bunch of water lettuce, a bunch of carrots, because that's what I have nearby, and any other food we have. Yay! Okay, I think the water lettuce really helped. Oh, 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 oh. Oh my gosh. Sorry, guys. Oh, there he goes! Gordo slimes! Gordo slimes are a rare phenomena that occurs when multiple slimes of the same type congregate. The result is that the slime seem to merge together into a much larger slime that is seemingly incapable of movement, which would be kind of concerning, honestly. A Gordo will eat until it bursts, causing all the slimes to separate once more, as well as revealing whatever object it was that caused the Gordo to form in the first place. Gordos pose no real risk to ranchers. They can only sometimes be a nuisance in that they are hiding something a rancher might need. So if you feed a Gordo, or if you see a Gordo, feed it. And then plortonomics, they produce no plorts of their own. However, the slimes they produce after bursting do like any normal slime. Hi guys! Oh my gosh, they're so cute! We're going into the rabbit warren. Like, that is just freaking adorable. All right. Hi! What were you guys hiding down here, hmm? Oh! That's where the tabby plorts are hiding! What the heck? Boy, you guys were hiding something pretty serious, weren't ya? Oh, and another one of these rock things. All right, maybe I'll gather a few of you guys. Well, to be honest, I should probably set, whoops. Okay, I need those carrots. I should probably set these guys free because I need the tabby plorts. Oh, you guys are way too cute. All right, sorry for all the screenshots. It's just the best way to be able to get a cute picture of them. Okay, so here we have some more plorts. And now, is that my jellystone? No. And now I need to figure out how to find my way to the other Gordos. So, is that the slime music? Ah! The tars, they're spreading! Oh, what do I do? Oh, what do I do, what do I do, what do I do? Where'd he go, where'd he go? Where'd he go? No! Okay, maybe that worked? I saved the day! Woo! I really need to be able to get the water stuff soon. That would be kind of nice. So I need to find some angler, some little anglers and get their goods. Oh, and this is actually the link to the refinery. Yes, so then I can just go ahead and send the jellystone in and then I can see how many of the various bits and bobs I have submitted. Excellent. All right, Tabby! Come here, you! Okay, so I got one tabby, which means there have to be more hiding somewhere nearby. Let's see. Aha! Yes! Here we are! So this is where I need to be. Whoops. All right. For the sake of these tabby plorts, which I need to drop. Oh, I'm sorry, Rooster Roos. I need to just watch the natural cycle of life here. Oh, but to hear the little cheekadoos just chirping and minding their own business. Oh my gosh, hello. It's been a long time since I've seen some of these guys. Oh boy, Oh boy, so there are a bunch of tabby slimes. Hey guys, will you eat these? No, because you can only eat meat. So yeah, that's the unfortunate thing, is the tabby slimes are indeed obligate carnivores. Which means if I'm going to get, well, until you do this, of course. I totally forgot about that. I could get around them being obligate carnivores by having them eat these other plorts. And then once they do that, I can feed them vegetables or fruit or anything. I can become famous for my carrots. Just like in our wonderful oodles of ooblets of ranch, my friends, since, you know, we pixel biologists travel across many worlds in order to study the pixelated creatures that occupy many world, like many, many different types of landscapes. Yes! All right. So I need like 10 of these, I think. So can I just continue to create largos, let them feast, and then collect these plorts right here. All right, so we're getting there. Oh, I am so happy for largos. Run, little hen! Run, little chickadoo! Oh boy. Oh boy, hello, friends. Run, little chickadoo! Okay, everybody seems to be getting kind of excited down here. Oh, they're so cute. I forgot how tabby slimes have no concept of personal space, too. They're just, like, on top of you. Oh, and you know, this makes me miss King Honeymint. He was always so good. His Royal Majesty King Honeymint. Maybe we'll visit him someday soon. Alright, now there's phosphor slimes here, which means that we're about to have some really bad news. I should probably run. Because things are about to get really chaotic. But we need these tabby plorts. I just need two more. Should I catch? You know what? Let's do it. We're going to try to catch some of the tabbies that are out and about. And then, oh, let's make some tabby cotton slimes. Oh boy. Oh no, my plorts. I need those plorts. Quick. Can I rescue? Can I rescue any more tabby slimes? No, my plorts. I keep throwing them instead of collecting them. Oh my gosh, this chickadoo! Okay. Oh boy. Okay, yeah, that's just mass chaos. Get in here, little friend! I've rescued three of them. I think that's as many as we're going to be able to snag for right now. Oh, the phosphor plorts arrive, or the phosphor slimes arriving. Oh. Oh my gosh, why do you only eat meat? No! No! I needed like a sacrificial hen just then! I saw a lucky slime! I've only seen the lucky slime like two or three times before. Oh my gosh. And tell me, this is gonna be a warp to a new place, because this is just gonna absolutely warp me to a new land, isn't it? While I'm like clutching desperately the last of my plorts. Oh boy. Oh, here we go. Starlight Strand. A vision of dusk and dawn together as one. Oh, wow. Oh. This wasn't part of my plans at all. All right, can I leave my plorts safely in here, perhaps? And like come back for these in just a little bit. I really hope we don't have any slimes eat these, but maybe I can leave them in that pond and nothing bad will happen. Everything is so shiny. Ah, everything is so pretty. Oh, there's multiple types of slimes. This is gonna be a chaotic mess. Oh, it's gonna be Largo City. Oh my gosh, what did I just collect? Oh, the buzzwax! So that's how you get the buzzwax. You have to go to specific spots where you can see the beehives. Can be used to make a great scented candle if you enjoy the smell of bee abdominal glands. What? Just like the bees on Earth, bees on the far, far range produce a waxy substance that they use to form their hives. Buzz wax is still malleable deposits of unused wax found in apiaries. It has many practical uses, ranging from building materials to medicines. You can also chew it as the worst gum in the world. Gross! And then using it on the ranch, deposit buzz wax into the lab's refinery, where it can then be used for crafting vac upgrades or slime science gadgets. Well, I got the buzz wax, and here's a whole bunch of carrots, and what does my map say? Oh, so it yeeted me over here? I bet there's another spot that the pink Gordo would yeet me over to the other side. Okay. I wonder if I should collect the phosphor slimes to try to prevent the chaos. Oh, I forgot they fly. That's so cool. Oh, they're all so cute. Wow. All right, maybe I'll release the phosphors like over here, because we're about to get lots of slimes eating lots of different plorts, and that's going to result in quite the mess. All right, let's explore. So are dawn and dusk always mixed together here? Here's more of these little rocks. I really want to figure out what they do. There's more phosphors. What are those? Oh, it's the rock slimes! No way! It's been so long! These slimes are totally metal. Huh, I love the pun. Rock slimes earned their name from the rocky crown of sharp spikes atop their slimy bodies, but their affection for minerals doesn't end with their appearance. Rock slimes are strict vegetarians, favoring the satisfying crunch of the heartbeat most of all. The dangers of a rock slime should be fairly obvious. Their rocky crown is sharp enough to pierce straight through a rancher's boots, but it's not all about watching where you're stepping, as these rocks are always rolling. When you see a rock slime revving up for a tumble, it's best to get out of the way. Rock plorts are prized for being a key component in the production of blue metal, an amazing alloy that's stronger than titanium and lighter than plastic. Because of its amazing strength, blue metal is often a key component in the hulls of light-speed capable starships, synthetic appendages, and protective holophone cases. Alright, so rock slimes could be potentially quite useful, and we do actually have quite a few, like, vegetables that we're already collecting. So maybe I'll gather up some rock slimes too. I think we need to start unlocking some of the expansions to our range so that we can try to keep everybody kind of in their own spot. All right, I'm gonna throw the buzz wax to the side so we can have the heartbeat. If you listen to it closely, you can faintly hear a veggie. Oh dear. Heartbeats get their name from their deep red color and heart-like shape. Heartbeats are also unusually juicy for a beet, making it the only vegetable that's not for the squeamish in the kitchen. Oh dear. Deposit a heartbeat into a garden's depositor and you'll have a large heartbeat crop of your very own. All right. And there's the cubes that I absolutely adore. Wow. Oh, heck. Oh, there's like some doors that I need to open. Oh man. What was that? That's a feral? That's a hunter slime, all right? Yeah, what do you think you're doing? Yeep! Oh man. I've never seen a phosphor hunter largo before. He's so angry. How do you make him not angry? Do you have to like a diet of fruit? Fruit? I don't have any fruit! Oh my gosh. Alright, is there any... Okay, what is that? Okay, can I get some fruit soon? Will that calm him down? Oh, now he calmed down. And look at this! Now we have the hunter plort! What? I could make a hunter largo if I really wanted to. I've never seen a hunter phosphor largo before. Okay, that's kind of hilarious. Because it has some of the cuteness of the tabbies. Hi, friend. You are trying to come in and defend this new area, aren't you? All right, he's kind of cute. I'm going to admit that. And we got his plort, which I might try to put in a safe place if I could. I don't think I can. So that we can try to go ahead and turn it into... Oh, what's this? What is going on up here? Oh, one of these water spots. Oh, you guys, there's just so much stuff everywhere. Okay, do I want to keep this hunter plort? What would a hunter rock slime look like? That might be really cool. All right, I think we need to go home, as much as I hate to say that, because I think I need to haul bunny hunkers. And like, oh, I want to go see that tree so bad. I need my jetpack, and I need a way to be able to go ahead and like collect more things. And look at all of this. Like, oh, I can't even gather up all of this buzz wax. Okay, yeah, this is so exciting. This is so exciting and so pretty, and I'm so going to die. I just have no idea how yet. So, all right, guys. Holy moly, I need to get home. And this is going to be quite fun to watch as we slowly but surely figure out how to grow from the teeny tiny little corners of the land that we're currently at into a fully functional farm in the future. But if you guys could, do please leave a like for that adorable hunter-like phosphor slime we saw. What the heck? It was so cute. And also leave a like for the hopes of being able to find my way home. What the heck? But most importantly, stay curious, my friends, and I'll see you guys next time. Oof, so many slimes. Bye-bye.